Hello friends and welcome back to She's in Her Apron. I am so glad you're here because today we're going to talk about long-term food storage. Now don't go, boring. You're going to want to know this stuff. So today I'm going to be sharing with you why you should have a long-term food storage, how much you should have, how to store it, and some resources for you. So let's jump right into it. Welcome back to She's in Her Apron. I am in my in-laws' cold storage room and it is cold in here. We are surrounded by cement underneath the front porch. So I've got my sweater on and I'm cold. So we're going to talk about long-term food storage today. I already shared a video about short-term food storage. It's a 3-month supply of food. That video is down below for you guys, so click on that. So today I'm going to be sharing with you why you should have a long-term food storage, how much you should have, how to store it, and some resources for you. Okay, so the first thing I want to share with you is my resources. There's so much out there, you guys, a ton. If you go on Pinterest, it'll bring you to a million websites with such great information. One of the things that I like to go to is this book here, as you can see, link for it is below. This is the LDS Preparation Manual. This is written by a member of my church, the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints. Our church doesn't promote it or advertise it or sell it, but this is where a lot of my information has come from. Also, my information has come from A Year Without a Grocery Store. This is from Karen Morris. This is phenomenal. This is her workbook. There is a smaller book of this separate that I bought first, then I bought this workbook. So you're gonna be looking for A Year Without a Grocery Store. Tons of information in the book and this workbook to keep you organized. And of course, just oodles of information over the year from going to classes, from family members. It's all over the internet. I have a lot of notes for you guys, a lot of resources. You're gonna see me reading it. You're gonna see me looking at my phone. There's just so much that I could not absorb. It can seem overwhelming, but once you get going, it's like cake. And I'll be sharing with you how we do a lot of it. And I was nervous about it. And I'm like, why was I so nervous? That was pretty easy. So don't worry. A question I pretty much get daily is why? Why do you do it? What's the purpose? I mean, if you needed something, couldn't you just go to the store? Yeah, totally could. I look at it as food insurance. We have earthquake insurance, fire insurance, flood insurance. Why wouldn't we have food insurance when we need it or don't need to run out to the grocery store? We need to be prepared for any situation. So as we've recently seen over this year of 2020, a loss of a job, cut back hours, a disruption in the chain of food can strike at any time very quickly. When emergency is upon us, the time to prepare pretty much has passed. My biggest thing is do not go into debt to do this. You're gonna work on this every month, inch by inch, little by little. You're gonna sit down, if it's just you or you and your spouse, you're gonna sit down and go, okay, what can we give each month to our food storage? And then stick with that. Your budget's gonna look different than mine. Your budget's gonna look different than your neighbor's. But the whole point is moving forward with it. Plan your budget like you would your savings account. Whatever percentage that you put away into savings, work out a system like that for your food budget. A problem with when something goes wrong, a storm is coming, you know, or there's a shutdown, you know that the stores are, like, the shelves are going to be emptied. We've seen this. We've all seen this all over the world, haven't we? We've seen this. We didn't go and get a whole lot. We got some medicines. I grabbed a couple of things I noticed that we were out of, but we didn't go crazy because we already had the things that we needed. When something happens to everyone at the same time, shelves empty. To give you another perspective, I got this from survivalblog.com. This struck me. It has been estimated that the average grocery store has less than 1 week supply of food. Oh my goodness! There's lots of ways on how our food could get to us could be disrupted. My whole life, I've been counseled to have at least a year's supply of food. I did this growing up. And then Derek and I started slowly doing it when we were first married, but our budget was so small, we were able to get our hands on some number 10 cans of flour and sugar and dry milk and some oats and beans. And then later on, we were able to get our hands on big buckets of wheat, oats, beans as well. So we have been slowly doing this, but now we have been learning how we could do this on our own with oxygen packets and Mylar bags, and it's exciting. Just that security that we could provide for us if something were to happen, or just to live off on. And we went to our Year Without a Grocery Store book, and we read what she suggests, and we got to work. We only did a couple of things, and then I food savored a bunch of things. So let's jump in and go check that out. So here are the buckets that we got. They're from Berry Plastics. I found them on Amazon, but these buckets that I'm using, I know you can find on berryplastics.com. They are food grade, and once we press them down and seal them good, then the lid you have to pull here to get into them. So they're 5 gallons each. We just finished, well, this morning we washed them. We washed them really, really good, and they've been dried. Derek dried them with towels, with a hairdryer. We don't want any moisture. So that has been taken care of. Okay, so I bought 2 packages of Mylar bags. It helps keep things way long, especially when you use an oxygen packet. I'll link these, but I haven't opened them yet because then they're exposed. I know there's probably better ones I can get out there. I'm hoping that these weren't a dud. There's 10 in each bag. It's a 20 by 30, and you can get different sizes of Mylar bags. So I'm gonna be working with Mylar bags, oxygen packets, and I'm gonna be using my food saver machine. It's not gonna be major long-term doing it this way, but it's much longer. But I'm gonna be sharing with you what I'm gonna be food savoring up. Definitely the things that are oily, like your nuts and things that don't, that can't be used with an oxygen absorber. So we're gonna utilize the food saver as well. I have a lot of stuff here that I have out that I'm gonna be working with. I'm working with peanut butter powder and oats, dried milk, rice, lots of rice, pinto beans, trail mix. We're gonna seal this up. All-purpose flour, jasmine rice, I have some brown sugar, some black beans, and some hash brown potatoes, homestyle buttery potatoes, and some chicken bouillon. So this is what I'm working on right now, so let's get going on some of it. And in the buckets, we're gonna put bay leaves in because apparently the bugs do not like bay leaves, so it kinda keeps them away. So we're gonna be adding this at the bottom of the buckets and maybe in between a layer. So these bags are huge. Like, here's my hand. All right, we are working with a 25 pound bag of all-purpose flour. We got the Mylar bag in the bucket. Once we open these, we got to work with them quickly. So I didn't know much about oxygen packets when I bought these. These are 50 cc's and we need 2,000 for that. We've gathered 40 of the oxygen packets. That equals 2,000 cc. So those are going in. I'll remember now, knowing next time more what I'm doing. But you know, Derek and I are learning, and this is a good firsthand experience. So he's getting those in there. We're gonna use our cutting board here and our iron. You can also use a flat iron to seal your bags. And then when that is all sealed up, the oxygen packets will do its thing. Okay, so he's going to seal it lower and then we'll cut the excess.
Never done this.
I know, we never done it either. So we're all learning here. Okay, go all the way across. Doesn't have to be very long. And then you can do the other side. Okay, go over.
Oh, I got that. I need to turn that.
Do the other side. Flip it. There are some different lids I want to get. I think they're called gamma lids. They're the ones that you can twist, but those are the lids that I would love to get. For things like beans that you want to use periodically but able to stay fresh for a very long time, I think they're called gamma lids is what you're going to want. It has grips here and you can turn it. And it still has the seal around it. So that's what I want to look into next time. Next, we're going to do long grain rice. And this is a 25-pound bag. We're going to
put on the bottom and the top.
Yeah, we're going to put some bay leaves in. And you put the rest of the oxygen packets in, and then we seal up the bag with a hot iron. So while we continue to work on this project, I'm going to turn on Acorn TV. And I'd like to thank Acorn TV for sponsoring today's video. So you guys, you know how I like listening to things and watching things as I work? Well, Acorn TV is where I can find all the fun British shows, comedies, dramas. My mom and I are always calling each other up like, have you seen this show? Have you seen this show? And we love it, but sometimes it's hard to find them. So having them all in one place is so exciting. Their extensive library includes hard to find gems, so true, timeless classics, and newly discovered favorites from Britain, Ireland, and Australia. With Acorn TV, you get access to premium, commercial-free, international content, all from an unbeatable price of just $5.99 a month. Acorn TV works on all your favorite devices. Download the app or watch online with your Apple and Android devices, Amazon Fire TV, Google Chromecast, Roku, and more. You'll never run out of content because Acorn TV adds new releases every Monday. You could try Acorn TV free for 30 days. By going to acorn.tv and use the promo code She's in Her Apron. I know right now everyone's looking for a good Black Friday deal this week. Why not grab an annual membership as a gift for the holidays? When you buy one annual gift membership, you'll get the second membership for 50% off. You could buy multiple annual gift memberships after the first one, and the 50% off still applies. That is awesome. You can get these savings starting from November 24th through the 30th. So Ma, you go grab one, and grab one for Ashley. You guys, Ashley is our sister. We love watching British television, so this is exciting to us. Acorn TV is loaded with thousands of hours of binge-worthy content, and there's always something new to watch. So this will keep me entertained while I work on this food storage project. So now I'm gonna do some non-fat dry milk with my food saver machine here. I have already double sealed the bottom of my bag and I have this in here. What I'm gonna do is I am going to cut a hole at the top and then let all the oxygen suck out through the machine and do its thing. I am gonna drop in a couple of these in there, the oxygen absorbers too as well. Okay, I poked a hole up top. And then I have my oxygen absorbers. I didn't know how many to use. I'm just gonna use two. It's gonna seal really tight. So now I'm just gonna use my food saver machine and get this all sealed up. And then I'll double seal it like I did the bottom of this bag. We have a double seal on it. We can see that it's non-fat dry milk, so we're able to still keep it in its package and know how to use it. So there we go. Now, this was Best Buy June 2022. So this, I mean, you have a good year, but with it being in here, you could go a few years after this, you guys, with it being in here. I don't have an exact number of years, but it's gonna last you. It's not gonna last you 20 years or anything like that, but it'll last you quite a while if it's still tight and not going anywhere. So just keep an eye out, but that is awesome. So we've got one thing of instant dry milk done. This is the jasmine rice.
We added a bay leaf in as well. I'm gonna write on here jasmine rice and the month and the year that we did this, because we can already see the best by date, which is July 11th, 2022. Okay, so we labeled the buckets with some painter's tape. Just put the today's date and what it is and how many pounds. So that's how we are doing our buckets. So we have a lot more to do, but you get the gist of how we're doing it. What does a year's supply of food look like? So I started on Instagram sharing what to get for the month of November. I did this last week, if you didn't see it. It posted too on Facebook. So I got that from in here, and I've seen it on many websites and blogs of having a food storage calendar. So I got it from this book here. It goes over the whole year, what to get each week of every month for a year to help build your food storage. So I'm gonna be posting every month. It'll move over to Facebook if you don't have Instagram, but Instagram I really get on and talk more in the Insta story, so I hope you can, you know, get an account and hop on and join us over there. So for November, for this month, I shared that we're gonna get 4 large jars of peanut butter, 1 case of canned fruit, 15 pounds of rice, 7 number 10 cans of shortening. That's not something that my family would use all the time, so why don't you get butter for your freezer? And then the last week of the month, 50 pounds of rice and buckets to store that in. So and that's fun. And then I found another site that was super helpful of if you only wanted to spend $10 a week, some options that you can get for $10 a week for the month to get for your food storage. So please join me. I will post once a week what to get, and it's super helpful. This is how Derek and I started. I found a blog that did this, and I would add it into our food budget, create how much you want to spend, and this is what I went out and got. This got the ball rolling. This will give you an idea of what a year looks like. You can just do the bare minimum. So for an adult for a year, you would need 400 pounds of grains, 60 pounds of beans, 10 quarts cooking oil, 60 pounds of honey, 8 pounds of salt, 16 pounds of powdered milk, and 14 gallons of drinking water. That is for 2 weeks. So just how much is this? 2 5-gallon buckets will hold about 75 pounds of wheat, rice, or other grains. This means you need 11 buckets of grains for each person in your family. So that gives you an idea of the grains. So if you decide to store the grains in number 10 cans, wheat, rice, corn, etc., you would need 64 cans. Now pasta, you would need 32 cans. Rolled oats, these are lighter but bulkier, so they require more storage containers and space. You would need 124 cans. Beans for 12, 13 number 10 cans. Daily food, dividing 400 pounds by 365 days equals out, or just over 1 pound of grain per person per day. This is approximately 2 cups of unground grain to cover your breakfast, lunch, and dinner. This is not much food, folks. This is what they say. That sounds like a lot of food to me. They say that is not a lot of food. Get the basics, then immediately begin to add more kinds of grain, soup mix, canned and or / dehydrated vegetables or fruit, and add a variety and provide more than the minimal survival diet. As an example, the minimal recommended amount of grain when ground and prepared will yield about 6 small biscuits or a plate full of pancakes. It's enough to keep you alive, but a far cry from being satisfied and not hungry. This is part of the reason why I do a 3-month food supply storage. This is my go-to pantry. You've seen it before. This is my in-laws' go-to pantry, because these things will help sustain my long-term food storage that are in number 10 cans, buckets that we can add on and get more food in the day and more nutrition in our diet. So it's a lot if you think about it that way. I can't think about it that way because I think of the big picture and it just overwhelms me. So I just start working on it. I just go once in a while, once a month, go get a big bag of black beans or go get a big bag of pinto beans and long grain rice and oats and work on it. And something is better than nothing. That was a lot of information, but you know what? I'm gonna have oodles and noodles of references down below for you guys, so please click on those and get on the internet and look as well. There's so much out there on Pinterest that will help you to see what you need for a person for a year, how much of each that you'll need.
I just want to show you what this book has. They give you a basic food storage list. We're looking at grains. It goes over how you need 400 pounds per adult. It goes over all of the grains, pastas, milk and dairy, like dried eggs, cheese spreads. Don't forget your formulas for your babies, you guys. Powdered cheese, your juice mixes like hot cocoa, lemonade. And when I posted just the other day about having some juice powder, this is what I'm talking about, like your lemonade, your Gatorade powders, things like that. We have canned dried meats, fats, oils, auxiliary foods, like all your cake mixes and yeast. You gotta have yeast in your food storage, you guys. I would make that one of your number one things to get right now. Vegetables that you can get either hydrated or dehydrated. And fruit, yeah, your fruits and vegetables here. Lots and lots of veggie lists of things that you can find. Spices and sugars and this is their long-term master food list. Look at that. So much good referencing, so much. You don't have to get everything, you guys. It's just, you gotta go off of what your family eats. You know, if you're not gonna go through, you know, like I said the other day, the shortening, then get butter and put it in your freezer. So this gives you an idea.
Yeah, I wanna share with you Thrive. With Thrive, you can get a lot of freeze-dried vegetables. So I have a lot of this. This is what my mother-in-law has. I have some in my storage room in the area that we live in, and I have some in our storage unit that we need to start bringing over. We just need to make room for. So I have things like cheese powder, honey powder, egg powder, bouillons, potatoes, celeries, green peppers, red peppers, all of that. Now, this is what you can get from Thrive. I do have a link down below. It's actually an affiliate link. I loved them so much, I'm like, why don't I get an affiliate link? So that's down there for you, so you can check out their prices and see if you want to grab anything.
This is just some of the things that you can look for when you're shopping around on the internet to give you some ideas. But if you want to check out Thrive, go check out Thrive. But you can find some of this stuff in your grocery store as well. So, but not through Thrive. But here's things like spinach and broccoli, green beans, celery, peas, onions. You gotta have onions. I know I've got a ton of onions. There's jalapenos, zucchini, more onions, let's see, corn, red peppers, carrots. Oh yes, you gotta have carrots. Tomatoes, look at that. What kind of tomatoes are these? I don't have any of the tomato. Oh, tomato dices. I don't have any tomato dices yet. There's grapes and bananas and blueberries, and you guys have had all these fruits and they're delicious. They are so good. I've added them to oatmeal. Oh my goodness. There's pineapple and pomegranates and cherries and raspberries. Let's see, down here we've got squash, butternut squash, yams. Oh yeah, oh yeah, look at that. Let's see, potatoes. I have some potatoes. And then let's see which, oh, mushrooms. Yes, you gotta have mushrooms. What does she have over there? Looks like peanut flour. Peanut flour. Oh, she's got peanut flour. Honey, get yourself some honey. Honey powder. So they have refried beans, and they also have meal kits, you guys, where you can get a full meal, and just all you have to do is add water, heat it up, and boom, you have a meal. It's fantastic. So here is some instant black beans. And having the instant beans in a pinch is fantastic. Back here, she's got gravies and Scrambled eggs. That is on my list for next month, you guys, is scrambled eggs. I tried to get it last month, but they were still sold out, so that is on my list. And she also has instant white rice, brown rice. Right here is a rainbow pasta. So we have that. Chicken. You guys can get beef and chicken. Did you know that? So this is grilled seasoned chicken. So that's fantastic. This is chicken slices that you can get. And you can get chopped chicken and beef. Look at that. Diced beef. We actually have in our storage unit beef and chicken. I can't remember how much we have, but that was bought before our move. That was our big purchase for that month's budget, was we bought chicken and beef that was freeze-dried. She's got big things of green beans. Let's see. Oh, cheese. Look at that. You've got Monterey Jack cheese and cheddar cheese and Parmesan cheese. Sour cream powder. Oh my gosh. I gotta get me some sour cream powder. I'm excited about that. Butter powder. Yeah, I've got butter powder. I do know that. And then lots of instant milk. And you guys, this milk is delicious. We have used it and it tastes like regular milk. It is so good. The kids don't mind it at all. So that is just some of the things that you can look for when you're going for your cans. So when I was talking about number 10 cans, this is the size right here. This holds a gallon of food. There's, is it Augusta Farms? Is that their name? They're phenomenal too. So if you see them in the grocery store on the shelf, I know here in Utah, Walmart sells them. You can get those. So you could see you have quite a bit of options, and this helps you when you crack open your bag of wheat, when you crack open your bag of rice and beans, you're like, okay, great, I have beans, now what? Well, you can go over to your cans and get the rest of the things to make a great meal. And then you could go over to your pantry that you're rotating like every 3 months, and then you have everything to go with it as well. Well, friends, I hope this motivated you in some way to start thinking about having a long-term food storage and see the benefits of it. We live in a kind of a funny time, and we saw how fast things flew off the shelves. And so instead of panic shopping, we can prepare every month, and when something happens, we know we're gonna be good. You know, it might last for a short time, but we have something to feed our family. If you are struggling to feed your family now, and I just encourage you to please reach out to your church, to your community, to the school district. They will lead you to areas that can get you the help that you need. You know, we've all been in tough times. Derek and I have been in tough times, and our food storage has been there for us. So please reach out where you need it. We're not trying to be hoarders. We're trying to have security for our family, live of what we are using, and save money. In the end, this will save you money when you're shopping your home instead of always going out. Derek and I have had seen the benefits of this. You're not going to store anything that you're not going to eat. Okay? It's like couponing, when the couponing went crazy, you know, over the last how many years, or is couponing still a thing? Is it still going on? I don't know. I used to do it, but I noticed because of the deals I was getting, I was buying things that we normally don't eat. And then guess what? We didn't eat it. A lot of things I ended up giving away and to canned food drives and to shelters. If you're not going to eat it, don't grab it. Because when you're in a pinch or a disaster happens and you have to go to your food storage, it's gonna be very like, oh, it's not gonna be very motivating to eat. Now, I encourage you to start eating from your food storage. It's not there to just sit and wait for a rainy day. Start using it. We dip into our wheat buckets often, okay? Very often. I'm grinding wheat for bread, and then I go and replace it. So if you've seen on a few hauls, I've grabbed another bucket of wheat. Use what you have.
A good rule is when you go shopping, buy one for now because you need it for your recipe and grab two or three for later. This will help bulk up your food storage. I hope this helped you. Any tips or tricks you have for us, please leave it down below. And while you're working on this project, go watch a fun British show on Acorn TV. Don't forget to go check them out down below and use the promo code She's in Her Apron. Thank you so much for joining me and we will see you soon. Bye. It is so cold in here. Brr. Look at this. She's in her apron. It's so cold in here.